to reset.
That's a lot, man. You're too serious, too hard for a series. It's always good to have a day to yourself and just relax and kind of calm down and get ready to play again.
Terry, I know you're checking in with Kyrie periodically. How much will you lean on him heading into this series?
No, big time. But, you know, he's around. I'm pretty sure I'll get him on this trip. He's always going to be there for me to talk to, whether it's something I can get better at, something I can see, things like that, me becoming more of a leader. I know he's there, so I'm going to use that to my advantage.
He told you he's going on this trip?
No, I just said I think he's going on this trip.
You watch a lot of film. What do you see, how they've changed in the second half of the season?
Besides LeBron just playing out of his mind, you know, he's just Kevin Love, always a huge help. J.R. Smith when he hit his shots, Kyle Korver, gotta treat him like J.J. Redick, not letting him get good looks. Obviously, you want to try to slow down LeBron as much as you can, but you can't let them other guys be special. And when the other guys is playing special, the Cavs is one of the toughest teams in the NBA.
I know it's obvious, but what do you see LeBron doing so well, even now, as he continues to, you know, to just be the dominant player that he is?
He's out here doing whatever you want. It's nothing against the defense. You know, sometimes you're not tall enough to block his shot, things like that. But you can try to affect his shot as much as you can by you know, showing hands, being long off the ball, and just being active, showing bodies and stuff like that. So, you know, we understand he's gonna make some crazy plays. You know, that's LeBron. But we gotta try to make it as tough as we can. We know he's not gonna make every crazy play every time down. So, you know, we just gotta show bodies and, you know, show our energy and length.
How have the first two series prepared you guys for this, defensively?
You know, well, we didn't see, like, when you got transition and rebounding, both teams love to do that we just faced. You got Milwaukee, is kind of similar to the Cavs. You got Giannis always trying to push the ball in comparison to LeBron. You got the shooters that you got to pay attention to, you know. And then playing against Philly, they're kind of like the Cavs, too. They like to flare on the weak side and stuff like that and always being active. Keep you on your toes. So, you know, both teams was unique, and I feel like they got us prepared for this. And this one is going to be a great test for us, great match, and, you know, I feel we're ready.
Jalen yesterday on Instagram said, keep counting us out. This is a team who enjoys and thrives in that underdog role. What is it about you that you enjoy about that?
You know, it's just, we've got everybody just counting us out, but we knew from the beginning we had each other, and like I've been saying, we wasn't going to lay down for nobody, no matter who was counting us out. We wasn't just going to let the teams come in and punk us or none of that. We was number two seed for a reason. With injuries, without injuries, we finished number two seed. So obviously we was doing something great all season. And what he said, it's true. You can keep counting us out. We'd rather y'all count us out. We don't want nobody on our side now that we're doing good. We play better when our back is against the wall and everybody.
Like
I've been saying before, I'm already self-motivated, so I don't really pay attention to what people are saying that they're too late. I wake up every day, how can I get better, how can I help my teammates be successful, things like that. I try to control what I control, worry about us, not worry about nothing else.
I know you guys just keep going, but how much have you, you know, yesterday, you have a chance to reflect on how much fun this run has been for you guys and the team?
Wow, man, it's been good. And sometimes you need a day like that because everything's just happening full circle. After we finished the series one, two days after that, we was right into series two. And so you don't get a chance to take a day to yourself and just, you know, realize how things are going. But that was good for us to get that day off yesterday, and you know, we're ready to go back at it.
Is this fun?
Oh, it's so much fun. Y'all having fun? I know y'all.
100%.
It's fun. It's a lot of fun.
Terry, you're from Youngstown, Cleveland. What's it like to face, one, the hometown team, two, LeBron James, as much as, I mean, you face younger teams in Milwaukee and Philadelphia, but this is like the dude that posters on the wall, played him in 2K. You've seen him, you've been in the league since you were in elementary school, and to kind of look up and see that that's the obstacle you have to overcome.
That's funny you said that, because yesterday, you know, just they showed a flashback of him playing against the Celtics and all that stuff. And, you know, we were young. We got guys that his first, I think, Eastern Conference final, I think Jason Tatum was not. So, I mean, it's just all unique. it's all unique. And I remember the days like yesterday, me, you know, watching him with my friends, watching him play against the Celtics, or watching him play and put and make his push in the playoffs. And now, you know, I get to go against him. It's, I can't put it into words, but, you know, I'm excited, but at the same time, I want to compete. I want to beat him. So, you know, you always get to have that on your resume for forever. And that's something I want to do, you know, but it's a lot of fun. Something that I look forward to, something that we all look forward to, we all excited about.
With that matchup against LeBron, how does Marcus Morris's defensive versatility give you guys a boost?
Oh, it's going to be great. It's going to be great. He's going to you know, be in his space, make it tough for him as much as he can. Him, Smart, Al, you know, and it's great for us to have guys like that to you know, try to make it as hard on him as we can. And, they do a good job of that. And their job is not easy. Job is not easy. Nobody can guard LeBron one on one. You can make it as tough as you can, and with the help from everybody else, I think we can do the job now.
Terry, for you individually, you had a couple of really strong games against Cleveland this year coming off the bench. What do you think led to that success against that team in particular?
I don't know exactly. Obviously, I'm going to go watch the film today and you know, figure out ways that I can you know, do things to help myself and help my team. I feel like during the season, I was coming off the bench. I wasn't so much a factor to them, things like that. But, you know, obviously I'm starting now. And, you know, when you're in the playoffs, the team's prepared. So, obviously, I got to see how they're going to play me and things like that. And you know, just try to do what point guards do, watch film, and, you know, how can I get better?